You know what time it is. The king's back. It's been 10 years since the last movie, and now he's barely in it at all. I mean, I'm serious. If you haven't seen the movie, he is barely in the movie. But once he's in the movie, man, it's like game on. It's so awesome. It is so freaking awesome. But the build up to that, it just drags, and quite frankly, I didn't really care much about the human characters. But you know, that's the same thing with pretty much all of the Godzilla movies. I liked the human characters in the original 1954 version. But from there on out, I don't care about the human characters. And this one seemed to be one of the worst when it came to that. I mean, if you guys have seen Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, or you've seen Godzilla vs. Gigan, then you'll know that those movies, they start out with human characters, and Godzilla, or any monsters at all, don't really come in until like 40 minutes into the movie. Now, that wasn't the case with this one. I mean, it had Godzilla in the beginning, kinda. It was just kind of like his fins, like his dorsal fins going like through the water. But it didn't show him in full until quite a while into the movie. It showed a lot of the two new monsters. They're called the Mutos. And, you know, they were alright. They weren't creative at all. I mean, if you've seen any of the Japanese movies, the monsters get really creative. Like, Gigan, the one I was talking about, he has like a buzz saw on his chest, and you know, he's just awesome. But these monsters were so generic, so, you know, it's so cliche. I mean, you've seen these monsters all the time, and it didn't do it for me, really. I didn't really enjoy the two monsters very much. I didn't think they had much of a storyline. And plus, you know, I would have enjoyed it more if I saw Godzilla more, and that was kind of a letdown of the movie. But with that said, like I said before, once you see the monsters, it's amazing. The only problem is, the first time you see Godzilla, I mean, it's this huge buildup. He just gets up right out of the water. He's huge. You see another monster, and you think they're gonna fight. He roars, and human characters, of course. You know, I've heard that said a lot with the reviews, but I have to bring it up because that's one of the big problems. There was a really cool moment again at the end. The ending was phenomenal. I loved the ending. It was easily and by far the best part of the whole movie. But there's a part in it that reminded me of King Kong. Now, I'm not going to spoil it, but if you've seen it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And if you are going to see it, then just keep that in mind. And once you see it, you'll know what I'm talking about. If you've seen King Kong, here's a hint. But yeah, it was really cool, that part. And the buildup of Godzilla himself was really cool. Like I said, I didn't like not seeing Godzilla much, but it almost in a way kind of helped the film a little bit because it made the parts where he was in the movie just so much more exciting. Because, you know, you go into the movie wanting to see these monsters fight, which is what you want to see in any Godzilla movie, but the majority of the movie is just the military and the human characters just talking. And that's not fun. That's not what you came to see. But the build-up, though, of Godzilla was actually, I don't want to say it was well done, because I didn't enjoy it going into it, but once we got to it, it was just absolutely fantastic. It was an amazing climax to the movie, and it redeemed some of the movies, like Boar Factor. One of the best parts in the movie, though, and I don't mean to spoil anything, but it's very minor, but, you know, just stop the video if you don't want to hear anything about the movie. But going into the movie, I didn't think that he was going to have atomic breath. I wanted him to, but I didn't see it in any of the trailers or anything like that. I didn't see it the majority of the movie, but he wasn't in the majority of the movie. But once he did breathe fire, it was so cool. He's fighting at the end, and if you've seen the Godzilla movies, you would know, like, when he starts to breathe fire, like, the blue goes up his dorsal fins, up to his neck and out his mouth. So it was very slow, and I think they did this on purpose. My dog's barking. The blue went up, and it was very, very slow, and I'm a fan, and I knew exactly what was going on. I was like, please, 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 please. And then it stopped for a minute, and then the atomic breath just flew out, man. I started cheering with my friend, and it was an amazing experience. I'll never forget that. I'm glad I saw it in theaters for that one scene. That one scene just kind of redeemed the whole movie, and from there on out, I was on the edge of my seat, you know? I was almost standing up. It was so exciting. But, you know, all in all, it wasn't that bad of a film. It needed a lot more Godzilla, which is what you came to see. And with that said, there's not much more that I really need to say on the matter. I would like to see a second Godzilla. And, you know, I'd like to see, like, a whole nother series, because every time they've come out with a reboot, with the exception to the 98 version, they've always had a new series of Godzilla films. Like, when Godzilla 2000 came out, they called it the Millennia series. It became a whole nother series, ending with Final Wars in 2004. So, for being my first Godzilla movie seen in theaters, I loved it. Could it have been better? Yes. Could it have been worse? Oh, yes. I mean, do I even need to bring up the 98 version? I don't think I do. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'm about done editing it. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe. And next coming up, X-Men Days of Future Past. With that said, have a good day or night, depending on when you watch this. And see you later.